love water. I've never lived somewhere where there isn't water really close nearby. It's so important to me. And my favorite body of water is probably a lake or a tide pool. Ooh, a tide pool. A tide pool is my favorite body of water. So, and when you see a tide pool, usually you're like this, down with your head really low looking in it. So that's my favorite body of water. And I'm so excited to have all of you here today joining me at Shadow Cliffs Regional Recreation Area. We're all the way out in Pleasanton, so not so close to Oakland. We're in a farther out park today. And let me actually show you where that is. Let me share my screen so I can show you where we are today. It's going to take me just a second, and things will be sideways for a moment as well. Give me just a moment. So this park, just a couple things before I tell you too much about this park. Let's see. Okay, so let me put you, is it right side up now?
All yes. Right.
Perfect. Okay, so right now we can see right there. Oh, I see right now Camila wrote, my mom's favorite body of water is a lake. Awesome. So we've got lots of lakes around here. So you can see all the bodies of water that we have. Oh, Lake Tahoe. Nice. You can see all the bodies of water. We've got the bay here. And let's see. So we've got the San Francisco Bay. And then we've got some different lakes. Lake Temescal is a lake we've been to. And then here we've got the Delta. So there's all sorts of different bodies of water, and it's all connected, headed out to the ocean right out there. So let me show you where exactly we are by zooming in. Let me just zoom in. So right now you can see Oakland, where Oakland is. And then if you were to go out, zoom back out a little bit, and we go out, and Shadow Cliffs is all the way out, kind of in between. You can see Livermore and Pleasanton, and there is a lake here. It was actually built in an old quarry, and we right now are actually, you can see, let me just circle that so everybody can see. We've got Shadow Cliffs right here, and then Oakland is right over here. So we're a little bit farther away than usual today. So where I am right now is actually not at the lake, but I'm at the arroyo, or a river, right behind me. So I'm going to actually flip you around so you can get a little bit closer of a look at what I'm seeing, because there's a lot of different life here. So we've so far, we've been to the bay together on Shine Online, and we've been to some other places as well. I want to zoom in just a second. Let me get. One thing I am noticing, I'm wondering if the speaker view is set to me. Does everyone have it set to me? Because I actually don't have it set to me. So I'm just double checking on that. So I'm just going to actually walk a little bit over here so you guys can see down the river a little bit. And we can actually see. It's a beautiful day out here today. And does anybody see? There are some different animals. What are some animals we can think of that might live here?
Frogs?
Yeah, there are definitely frogs here.
What else can live there, guys? Dragonflies.
Dragonflies. Oh my gosh. Today, I'm hoping that we're going to see a ton of dragonflies. I saw some already. So I'm hoping we're going to see some more dragonflies. And actually, down below me, oh yeah, there are definitely fish. Down below me, I'm actually seeing damselflies as well. Do you see all this green stuff down there? So it almost looks like you could walk on it, but I'm actually going to. Where'd my stick go? Oh no, I think I left my stick over there. I'm gonna have to find another stick because this green stuff, this is actually called duckweed, and it kind of looks like you almost could walk on it. Oh yeah, some of you knew it was duckweed. It almost looks like you can walk on it, but it is actually not solid, even though it kind of looks a little bit solid. So I'm just gonna walk a little bit farther up, look around and see if I can find myself something to throw in. I left my stick over there, I think. There's a lot of people who are biking here. Great, I found my stick because it's important sometimes when you're by a river to throw things. Oh, great, we have Joseph and Evelyn have joined in. So, another thing I wanted to show you. So let me go ahead and I'm gonna direct this down and then I'm gonna throw it. Here's the stick. So I want you to watch and we're gonna see what happens when I throw the stick in. Oh, did it. I think I got a little too close actually, but do you see right there? It's closed back in. Wish I had another stick. I'll find another one later. We can check that out. But I also wanted to walk and show you this plant right here. So this plant is one that's very important to people who have lived in this area for over 10,000 years and still live in this area. And that is the Ohlone Indians who have called the East Bay and called this area home for thousands and thousands of years. And this right here that we're looking at is called Tule. And Tule is pretty cool for a lot of reasons. You can see this is kind of like the little flower part here. And Tule is pretty incredible because it can be used to make boats because it floats. And it also can be used to make homes as well. So this is traditionally used for lots of different things and it's still used today. So Tule is a really incredible incredible plant. So we are not in a swamp. Sometimes rivers have kind of a swamp-like look to them, but we are not. And maybe sometime when we're together again in person, we might be able to use some tea and see what we can see and actually watch when maybe try and float things around. So we're gonna keep walking and try and get a little bit closer. So we might be able to see some turtles. Or we might be able to see some ducks and things. And so this park is a great one to come out to because it's a nice, got lots of nice flat trails. Oh, there's a plant that I want to show you. And this plant, not gonna get too close. Do you see what plant I'm looking at? Anybody recognize it? Poison oak, exactly. Yeah, we've got poison oak. So if you check this out, you can see we've got our one, two, three leaves. And you can also see, got a nice smooth stem. And it gets its name because it looks a little bit like an oak tree. This is actually an oak. You can tell it's an oak, number one, because I'm touching it. But you can see they have really similar shaped leaves. And something really cool about the poison oak right now is that it flowered not too long ago, and we actually have some poison oak berries. And I'm going to be very careful because I don't want to get poison oak. that you can actually see. Do you see the little green berries underneath there? And animals actually eat those berries. So poison oak berries are a super important food, and so are leaves. Has anyone here, if you've gotten a poison oak rash before, raise your hand. Has anyone ever gotten a poison oak rash before? I know I have. doesn't feel super, super great. Oh, so right now I can hear there are some quail, and we might get a chance to see them, but they're making a nice sound that says that some people think sounds like Lake Tahoe, Lake Tahoe, Lake Tahoe. All right. So there's a spot right here where we're going to get a little bit closer to, let me spin you around. So right here, do you see we're getting a little bit closer down to the water? And oh, this is perfect. So you can see we're a little bit closer. And now I'm gonna try this again. We're gonna try and throw something in it again. You ready? Oh. I keep missing where you can see it. I have to throw farther. Apparently I'm not very good at throwing is what I've learned. So also, if you look, there aren't any out there yet. It's interesting, but what I'm looking for on these logs, who do you think might want to hang out on those logs? What kind of animal might want to be there?
Frogs? Oh!
Frogs and turtles. Yeah, oh, Savannah got it. Yeah, so this is a picture of a turtle. This is not one right now. But I did see these turtles just the other day here. And this is called a red-eared slider. And you can see that bright red color on it. And how many of you here have ever thought that you wanted to have a turtle for a pet? Has anyone thought that they wanted a turtle for a pet before? Yeah, I know. Yeah, it sounds pretty cool. Now, you want a turtle for a pet? Right. Turtle sounds like a pretty cool pet. Now, here's the crazy thing. If you were to guess how long a turtle lives for, if you think it can live for 10 years, put your hand on your head. If you think they can live for 20 years, give me a thumbs up. If you think they can live, yeah, looks like Dr. Nushin just wrote 100 years. Yeah, turtles can live for like 100 years.
I was joking.
No, they really can.
We were joking.
Probably that kind of turtle isn't going to live 100 years, but they can live for a really long time. So if you get a turtle, it's a commitment. It's like a lifetime commitment. So you'd have it when you graduated high school and when you graduate college. And yeah, you'd have it for a really, really long, long time. So one of the things that sometimes happens is those turtles get released. And those red-eared sliders aren't the normal kinds of turtles that live here. And so they actually compete for food for it. Yeah. So this next part of the walk, what I want to do is I want you all to go ahead and I want you to wiggle your fingers for me. Wiggle your fingers. So around you. So you're not here with me, but I want you to kind of get a little bit of an idea of what I'm experiencing. And so what we're going to do is we're going to do a part of our walk where I'm going to touch some different things. And I want you to guess what you think it feels like and then find something near you that feels like that. So for example, let's look this right here. We're looking at some bark. And if you were to feel this, what do you think it would feel like? What do we think this would be like?
Rough
or bumpy, I saw. Mm-hmm. So I want you to look around. Is there anything nearby you in your house that feels a little bit rough or bumpy? And if it's right near you, go ahead and touch it. And imagine that you're touching this log right here. Does anybody touch anything? Oh, your wall is a little bit rough. Nice. And then, does anybody else touch anything? Now, how about this plant right here?
I wonder what kind of plant it is.
Prickly? What kind of plant? What kind of plant is it, Morgan?
This is actually a Himalayan blackberry. It's not a California because it's got 5 leaves. And actually it is quite pokey. So I want you to find something nearby to you that's a little bit pokey and go ahead and touch it. Kind of like you're touching this plant here. All right, let's see what else we can find as we're walking along. All right. So you can see where, so the river is just to the right. And oh, I'm starting to see a lot of something on the ground. Let me get it. Oh, I'm frozen. Oh, it's fixed now. You see that right there? You imagine that this might feel like if you were to touch this. And you can either write it in the chat or you can unmute yourself. Fluffy?
Furry.
Hey, Hanson.
All right, so let's make sure everybody, we're gonna just have you use the chat and not unmute yourself just because it can be a little bit tricky. So yeah, we've got some fluffy. So I want you to go ahead and touch something near you that's a little bit fluffy or maybe soft.
Web.
Oh, I see some people touching their hair. That was actually one of my first thoughts. I was like, oh, some people's hair. Here's some more fluffy. All right, let's keep on walking. Let's see if we can find some other textures around as we're walking. Ooh, all of the fluffy stuff is flying through the air at me. All right. You can see we're very close to the river still. Still no turtles. The turtles are being secretive today. Maybe it's too hot and they all went for a swim. Now, let's see. I want you to imagine I'm close right now to this water. What do we think this water feels like? There's lots of fluff in the water. What do we think the water feels like? And remember, you can use your chat feature.
It feels cold.
Cold, warm. Okay, so we have a couple different thoughts, cold or warm. It feels thirsty. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna carefully touch it. It feels cool to the touch, I would say. Not cold, but cool to the touch. You can imagine if you were a little duck, this would be like a perfect little secret spot for you to hang out and feel nice and safe. So I want you, if you've got some water nearby, go ahead and take a drink of water. If you've got some water nearby. Maybe it's some nice cool water. And we'll keep on walking. And we'll see what else we've got that we can touch. So this, Ooh, see something that is just beginning. Check it out. What do we have?
Raspberry.
Yeah, kind of looks like raspberry. You're right. It's about to, so these just turned, these are red and they will turn into blackberries. So they're just not quite ripe yet, which is why they're still red. So there's a bunch of them all over the place here. So there'll be lots of good food for the different animals. All right. I love blackberries too. They're one of my favorites. All right, so we're gonna keep on walking along. And as we walk, let's see, there's some other, let's go ahead and I want you, we're gonna look closely at this leaf right here. And if you look at the edge of it, what do you think that feels like if you were to touch the edge of that? Sharpish, spiky. Yeah, I think these are pretty new leaves, but I bet as they get a little bit older, they might be a little bit spiky. So it's like a soft spikiness almost. So maybe, you know, it could feel like a little bit like the ends of your hair almost, like kind of like a little bit pokey, but not too pokey. And that was not a bay. There actually aren't really too many bays right here. oh my gosh. This, I should have waited for the fluffiness. I don't know why I did the fluffy so early, because check this out. So much fluff. So this is, what does this remind you of?
Cotton.
Cotton. Yeah. And this is actually from a cottonwood tree. So spot on. And you can see it's all over to be a nice little soft spot. Oh, the damselfly is just landing. Do you see right? Oh, he just flew away. So I was seeing, let me show you the animal that I just saw land. And we're gonna hopefully see another one of these. Do you see this little? Yeah, so these are called vivid dancers. I think is what most of the ones that we're seeing are. And I don't know why a picture showed up. So these are not dragonflies. They're similar to dragonflies, but they are not actually dragonflies. If you look, you can see that their wings stick backwards. So if you look, their wings go, some reason it's not letting me mark on it. Oh, because I'm on eraser, that's why. So their wings go in that direction, whereas if you were to look at a dragonfly's wings go out like this. So let me actually show you a picture of a dragonfly, and then hopefully we'll actually see one in just a minute. So this is a kind of dragonfly that I actually have seen here. And you can see how the wings go out. So actually what I want everybody to do is we're gonna play a little game. Let me find a nice spot where I can put you down a little bit.
Where are you hiking at?
Where am I right now?
Yes.
At Shadow Cliffs Regional Recreation Area.
Where is that at?
Out in Pleasanton kind of area.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so right now, what I want everyone to do is you need to find a spot where you can stand, up, and you're gonna be able to stretch around. I'm gonna set you down for a minute and I'm gonna move back a little bit farther so you're gonna be able to see me. Okay, so can you see me? Yeah, give me a thumbs up if we can see. All right, so what I want you to imagine, so we're going to play a little game of what I like to call Ranger Says, instead of it being, you know, like Simon Says, Ranger Says. And if Ranger Says dragonfly, you're going to stick your wings out like this, because dragonflies have wings that go out like this. So everyone, Ranger Says dragonfly. Let me see your dragonfly wings. And then Ranger Says damselfly. And if I say damselfly, you can stick your wings out behind you like this, because they've got those wings out. So Ranger Says dragonfly. Ranger Says damselfly. Now remember, if Ranger doesn't say it, you shouldn't do it. So if I say dragonfly, you shouldn't make a dragonfly. And I'll have some other things I'll have you do too. Okay. Ranger Says touch your nose. Ranger Says hop up and down like a frog. Ranger Says touch your nose. Ranger Says dragonfly. Damselfly. Ranger Says damselfly. Ranger Says quack like a duck. Quack, 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 quack. Ranger Says ribbit like a frog. Ribbit, ribbit, ribbit. Ranger Says move slow like a turtle. Damselfly. Ranger Says damselfly. Ranger Says dragonfly. Ranger Says swim through the river. Ranger Says eat a blackberry. Ranger Says dragonfly. Ranger Says damselfly. Dragonfly. Ranger Says dragonfly. Ranger Says damselfly. Dragonfly. Ooh, even I got myself on that one. All right. I think that's good for right now. We might do more a little bit later. All right. So let me get us back up.
Can't hear you.
Oh, sorry. Thank you. All right. So we're going to look around, and we just want to make sure everyone, if you can help us out, just so that way we don't have too many mixed noises, that everybody but me should stay muted, and then we'll unmute you if we need, but you can use that chat feature as well. Ooh, I see another thing. That's a good texture to touch. Let me. What do we think? Oh, I got frozen. Can you see what I'm looking at? There we go. How about this? How do we think this one feels? I'll tell you, this one is very, very spiky. Yep, another spiky one. All right, let's go ahead and. Let's see if they'll get a little bit closer. There's some birds that were hanging out in here. You're fine. There's some bright yellow birds. So this tree is filled with birds. It's kind of hard to see, but if you were with me right now, you would actually be able to hear all the different birds. So I'm going to go just a little bit farther because we've only got a little bit more time to hike together. And I am going to walk just a little bit farther to show a couple of different things. And the first thing is this plant here. Look at how big this plant is that I'm looking at. And I'm gonna walk right up to it. And what do you imagine this feels like? And see how my hand is moving across it. Smooth. Mm-hmm. So this plant right here, I want you to find something near you that's smooth. And go ahead and touch it. It does look a lot like bamboo. It's similar to bamboo. I don't think you'll be able to hear it too much. I'm gonna get my ears a little bit close. Kind of hollow too. So if you can find something near you that's maybe a little smooth, go ahead and touch it. Maybe your table or something near you. And then if there's something hollow, you can go ahead and knock it. I was waiting on someone to do that. And this plant right here that we're looking at, this is a giant reed. And this reed Does anybody here play any musical instruments that use a reed? Like maybe a saxophone or a clarinet or any other kinds of reeds? Or seen someone? This is actually the plant that's used to make those reeds. So these actually are kind of an escapee of, and not, oh, a lizard just ran in front of me. All right, so we're gonna go just a tiny bit farther because there's a good spot where I'm hoping to find dragonflies, and then we are going to wrap ourselves up. So as I'm walking, let me flip you around so you can look at where we are during this last little bit that we're walking together. You can see lots of little spots where animals can hide out and move. And then this spot right here, we're very close. You can see we're getting back to a nice view of the water. And often right here on these branches, sometimes we get, there's a dragonfly coming at me right now. Just landed a little bit farther away. So while we're waiting for them to come, I'm gonna show you a couple of the different dragonflies that we actually have here, and you'll recognize. They're really very colorful. They're really super colorful. So this is one that lives here, and you can see how it's got its big, long body, and it's got its wings that are sticking straight out. And it does have really teeny tiny antenna. And we usually see dragonflies near water because they actually need water to lay their eggs. And their larvae are actually in this water. And they're pretty hardcore. Seems like our dragonflies are hanging out a little bit farther away. Yeah, they like to hang out in lakes and rivers. Any small amount of water, they're usually happy with. Oh, I see one of the damselflies. I'm gonna try and get a little bit closer to it. Oh, he just flew away. Kind of a little bit tricky to see. I was hoping some of the dragonflies would come a little bit closer, but they seem to be being a little bit shy today, but that's all right. They're definitely out here, and this is a perfect spot for me. Oh, there is a big red one that just is flying around right now. And that red one that I showed you earlier, he's just flying around. So here's my hope, is that someday, you know, nature doesn't always cooperate. It doesn't always show up. Oh, you saw it. Oh, good. I was like, nature doesn't always show up exactly where you want it. So hopefully we will have a chance to come out here someday together and explore together. And so a couple of things. So remember, we were at Shadow Cliffs Regional Recreation Area today. We felt all kinds of different textures. We felt things that were smooth. We felt things that were rough. We felt things that were soft. And we had a chance to see all kinds of different animals that call this place home. So with that, I want to thank you all for joining me here at the lake and at the river. And I'm going to turn it back over to Dr. Nusheen, who's going to introduce our special guest, who's going to be helping with our closing circle and rejoining us for our closing circle because she's now part of our Shine family. So thank you all so much for hanging out with me today. And I'll pass it back over to Dr. Nusheen.
Morgan. Bye-bye. Thank you so much. It really such a fun thing to explore nature with you. And I even though it's really just an honor to explore nature with you online, I do hope that all the families are able to get outside into real nature at least once a day to be outside. Sorry about my nose. It is really important to keep your bodies physically active during this time. And we're so grateful for Morgan helping us connect to the outdoors. Thank you. Really, such appreciation.
Of course. Yeah.
And So I'm going to say goodbye to everyone because I'm going to turn it over to Naima, who is an amazing Oakland artist who is part of the Shine family now. Welcome, Naima.
Oh, hi. Hello, everyone. I'm so happy to be back. So if you're feeling good after the walk, can you do this for me? Yay, awesome. So I know some of you are laying down, which is fine. If some of you have energy and you feel like moving your bodies, I so encourage that, especially this first song. It's a Bob Marley song, and it's called Three Little Birds. And much like the songs I picked last time, I tried to pick a song that you'll recognize a lot of the objects in them. They might be some nature references, some animals. So do your best to act it out if that's what you're doing, or you're welcome to just lay down and listen, or you can sing along too. Okay, could everyone go like this? Like you're saying no? Don't worry. Can everyone say don't worry about a thing? Okay, so this is a song we're gonna do. Ready? Can everyone hear the guitar? Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be all right. Mm-mm-mm. Don't worry, yeah, about a thing. I'm seeing some dance moves. 'Cause every little thing is gonna be all right. Verse one, rise up this morning, smiled with the rising sun. Three little birds pitched by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you, you, you. So here we go, don't worry. Don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be all right. Yeah, don't worry about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be all right. Rise up this morning, rise up this morning, smiled with the rising sun. I wanna see you acting it out. Three little birds pitched by my doorstep, singing sweet songs of melodies pure and true, saying, this is my message to you, you, you. Last time, don't worry, don't worry. About a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be all right. Yeah, I said, don't worry, about a thing, 'cause every little thing is gonna be all right. All right, give yourselves a hand. I love those dance moves. And if I wasn't seeing dance moves, I was so happy to see your face. Okay, we're gonna do one that's actually a song that I was taught in South Africa. So we're gonna go all the way to South Africa. And it's a song called Manono, and it's gonna require you. And I know we were not gonna have the mute on, but I'm gonna teach you a part. Who's ever done a call and response? It's like when a singer sings something. I see Morgan's done a call and response. Savannah, I see a couple other hands. So call and response, for those who don't know, it's when a singer is singing something and then there's a response from you. So this song is a special song our teacher Ganondo Sheila Mpele Kama taught us. She's an indigenous healer, traditional, she does traditional medicine. She uses plants, she uses nature. And this is one of the medicine songs that she taught us. And it's called Manono, which means the sacred baby spirit song. And she taught us to sing it whenever you want to come back home and this feeling of coming back home, right? And since a lot of us are in our homes, but it's easy to get stressed out at home, sometimes coming back home is a place within ourselves, right? So here's a song. So before I sing it, I'm going to teach you the part that is the call and response. Can everyone say wobia? Wobia. Okay, I'm just trusting. I see your mouths moving. Wobia manono. Good. So the part that you're going to sing is wobia. Let me make sure I'm saying wobia. Wobia, wobia manono. Can you repeat that with me? Wobia, wobia manono. So I'm going to sing wobia manono, wobia lekaya. Wobia, wobia manono. One more time before I start. So I'm going to sing wobia manono, wobia lekaya. Wobia, wobia manono. Okay? Is everyone getting it? It's hard because I can't hear you. Give it a try. Ready? Here we go. I'm going to start. Wobia manono, wobia lekaya. Wobia. Wobia manono, wobia manono, wobia lekaya, wobia, wobia manono, wobia manono, wobia lekaya, wobia, wobia manono, wobia, wobia lekaya, wobia, wobia lekaya, wobia manono, wobia lekaya, wobia manono. Wobia, wobia manono, wobia, wobia manono, wobia manono, wobia lekaya, wobia manono, wobia lekaya, wobia, wobia manono, wobia. Now we're gonna try it. We're gonna. It might sound crazy. I want everyone to unmute. I want everyone to unmute. Let's try it. And then if it's a disaster, we'll just unmute again. It's okay. Okay, so I'm gonna start, and when I it's hard for me to point when I'm playing guitar, so I'm gonna kind of use my head. Let's try it. Ready? Here we go.
Wobia manono,
wobia.
Your turn.
Oh, wobia manono.
Wobia manono.
Wobia
manono.
Traditionally, you use drums and clapping, so I decided to try to give it a spin off. One. Now I'm muted. Okay, great. So I'm going to sing one that is by the artist Desiree. It's a song that really soothes me. It's one that you can also act out. There's a lot of sort of scenes it plays out. It talks about listening. It talks about when it says you got to be bad, you got to be bold. What she means is not bad like doing bad things. She means bad in the good way, if that makes sense. Okay? Oh, I love you all too. So try to really listen to the words. And see if you can act it out, okay? All right, here we go. Listen as your day unfolds, challenge what the future holds, try to keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. You gotta be tough. You gotta be hard. You gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool. You gotta be calm. You gotta stay together. All I know, love will save the day. Herald what your mother said. Read the books your father read. Try to solve the puzzles in your own sweet time. Some may have more cash than you, others take a different view. My, oh my, yeah, yeah, yeah. I say listen as your day unfolds. Challenge what the future holds. Try to keep your head up to the sky. Lovers, they may cause you tears. Go ahead, release your fears. Stand up and be counted. Don't be ashamed to cry. You gotta be bad. You gotta be bold. You gotta be wiser. You gotta be hard. You gotta be tough. You gotta be stronger. You gotta be cool. You gotta be calm. You gotta stay together. All I know, love will save the day. All I know, love will save the day. Sing that part with me. All I know, love will save the day. Yes, it will. All I know, love will save the day. Yeah. All I know. Where's the twirling? We need some twirling on this part. Love will save. Yes, the day. We have 2 minutes left. Do we have time for one more short song in Arabic? Yeah, okay. This song is gonna start really slow. So those of you who feel like dancing, it's a good one, and it's gonna require you going really slow, and then it gets faster and faster and faster. Okay, then we're gonna end up on a really high energy note. Does that sound good? And again, no invitation, not obligation. No one is obligated to dance. It's an invitation. And the words are, it's an old Arabic song, and my parents used to sing it around the house, and it's like a love song. So ayunek sud means your dark eyes, so it's this love song, right? And so maybe think about someone in your life that you want to send some love to, and it doesn't have to be romantic love. It is in this song, but it doesn't have to be that. It's just a fun song to sing, okay? All right, here we go. Start out really slow.
في نظري
like the Arabic song. I saw that on the chat. That's okay, you know? You win some, you lose some.
Right, Naima, I think they were saying that it's hard to speak Arabic because it is a very challenging language.
Oh, yeah.
I've tried to learn it, and it's a deep...
It's hard. I don't even sing it properly because it's so difficult.
Yeah.
Well, how...
Naima, thank you so much.
This was so fun.
Thank you, really. It's so soothing and healing to have your presence and... To have both you and Morgan helping us raise our children is such an honor. Thank you for joining us today.
I'm so grateful to you, Nusheen, Dr. Nusheen, for inviting me, and so grateful to you, Morgan, for just teaching us so much. And thank you all. I just really was looking forward to seeing you all again.
And I see so many people dancing. I hope you guys dance the rest of today. And Morgan, to see you dancing out in nature was one of the highlights of my week. It was really wonderful.
I do it all the time.
Morgan, did you want to tell us about the thing that you put on the link?
Yeah, so I just put in the chat just a moment ago a link to the YouTube page where all of our outings will be on. Several of them are already there, so if you haven't joined us for previous ones, there are 3 already up, and then this outing will also go online so you can relive the experience or share it with other people as well. And then we will... also be together again on June 2nd. And I think the plan is we are probably going to be going to Oyster Bay, which is right on the shoreline, and there's some cool trees and all sorts of things to explore. So we'll see each other. Or no, it's not June 2nd. Maybe it's June 6th. The first Saturday in June. I don't know which day it is. But we'll see you all then together in the park. But like Dr. Rezani said, please go outside into your parks, into your neighborhood. There's nature everywhere. If you're close to a creek, you might see a damselfly. Even if you're not even super close, you might see them. They just need a little bit of water. So keep your eyes out for them.
And to all the families, remember, you need at least 1 hour of physical activity and outdoor time every day, however you can get it. And Moya says that our outing is on June 6th. And as soon as we're able to gather in person again, we will let you know. Naima says she's going to take song requests, but I think she's doing just fine with her own song. So amazing, Naima. You're an amazing, amazing guide for us musically. Thank you. Thank you, each family that's here. I look forward to please be well and take care of yourselves. And we will see you in about 2 weeks. Bye. Thank you.